Are you feeling like God is closing door after door, and now your back is against the wall, there's no place for you to go, and you're just confused, and you're feeling a little bit discouraged? If you'll just give me 5 minutes of your time, I want to encourage you today. Hey everybody, welcome to Thinking Out Loud with PJ. On this channel, I want to help you think different, and I want to do that by helping you think biblically. I got this crazy idea that kind of came from YouTube Shorts. We all know what YouTube Shorts are, right? YouTube Shorts are videos that are a minute or less long, and I've been trying to figure out how I could do those. Well, the reality is I'm a pastor. I can't do anything in a minute or less. There's nothing I can say to you that's going to be done in that amount of time. So I'm going to do my own shorts. I'm going to do 5 minutes or less for a short. So what I want to do during this time is I'm going to share with you something God has taught me out of my sermon prep for that week. And this last week, we were in Acts chapter 16, verses 6 through 10. This is the great Macedonian call. The amazing thing we see is Paul having this dream, and this man appears and says, please come over and help us. Come to Macedonia and help us. And Paul and his team jump on a ship and they sail to Macedonia, and God does great things through them there. But what I want to look at, what God encouraged me with this week, is how Paul got there, those closed doors that could have discouraged him. He had this burning desire to preach the gospel in places where it had not ever been heard. And so his goal was to kind of dip south in Asia Minor, but God closed the door. Luke doesn't tell us how, but God closed the door so he could not go into Asia Minor. So plan A of his plans, his good plans, by the way, great plans to preach the gospel to people, those were stopped. And so plan B was to go to Bithynia, and that was just a little bit farther north. And as he tried to go into Bithynia and preach the gospel, again, God just closed those doors for him. Now, Paul had a situation on hand, or an opportunity he had to deal with here. And he could either get discouraged or he could keep moving. And as he keeps moving, he finds himself in Troas. In Troas, he finds himself up against the water, a port city. There is no place else for him to go. God has taken these circumstances of closing these doors and literally funneled him to the sea. And now here he is, back against the wall, not having any idea why God shut the door. Plan A, no good. Plan B, no good. And so here he sits. And then he's sleeping at night, and he gets this dream that says to him, come over to Macedonia. Well, he's already in Troas. He's already in a place where he can assemble his team and get on a boat and sail to Macedonia. Why was he there? He was there because God closed doors. And I'm sure it didn't make any sense to Paul why God was closing doors until he had that dream. And this is how I want to encourage you today. Have you been in a place in your life where it feels like God has just been closing door after door after door? Because I know I have. I am in a season in life right now where it could be discouraging, but I'm not discouraged. I'm thankful. I'm thankful for God closing the doors that he's closed. You see, a little over a week ago, my wife has tested positive for the good old Rona. And that means that now I'm at home, I'm quarantined, I'm taking care of the kids, I'm working from home, I'm talking to you from home. And all of the things that I had planned, the people that I had planned to be with, the men that are in my life that I have a privilege of discipling or being discipled by, I can't meet with them. We have been online for church for the last 2 weeks, and we're going to be online again this next week. And man, this momentum that it seems that God has been allowing us to build, now, at least on our plans, is coming to a halt. It's stopping. Why is God doing this? But as I studied through Acts and I saw how discouraged Paul could have been, but he wasn't, he immediately was ready for that next thing. And it encourages me because it tells me that as God is closing these doors in my life for this season, that he has a plan for me. God is still building his church. When God closed the door for Paul, it didn't mean he was done building his church. It just meant that he had another place for Paul to be. When God is closing these doors in my life, it doesn't mean he's done with me. It doesn't mean he's done with our church. It doesn't even mean that we're going to lose momentum in our church. What it means is that God is closing doors for now so that I can be where he wants me at the time. And right now, he wants me at home. And I'm encouraged by that. I was frustrated by this idea that I had to be at home and not be able to do the things that I wanted to do. But as I studied Acts 16, verses 6 through 10, I was greatly encouraged. God has a plan for my life. If you feel like your back is against the wall like it was for Paul, know this. Know God has a plan, and it's better than any of the good plans you could ever have made. Because the Bible tells us we plan our way. We plan our steps, but our way is already ordered by the Lord. He's got it figured out. He has the right to say no and change our plans, but we trust him and we know he's got something better for us. That's what the Lord taught me through my sermon prep this week. If this encouraged you, hit the like button. Make sure to share it with your friends. And of course, if you haven't yet, make sure you subscribe. We'll see you next time.